We have this nice, beautiful question on the board that we need to solve. Well, this question is from exponential equation. And we need to apply some basic indices, if you have the knowledge of indices. And if you think you can solve this question, go ahead and give it a try. Solve and put your answer on the comment section below. You can pause the video and later, you know, play it to check your answer. I'm going to be showing you simple step on how to solve questions like this in no time. Well, if you are new to this channel, this is Spencer's Academy. We are focused on solving calculation questions across many courses. And if that's what interests you, go ahead and click the subscribe button, turn on the notification bell so you don't miss my future videos. Now let's get to it. We have 3 to the power of root x equal to 9 to the power of x. Well, according to indices, I can break this 9 down. So I have 3 to the power of root x equal to 3 to the power of 2. 3 to the power of 2 is 9. And it is raised to power what? X. So this gives us 3 to the power of root x equal to, according to indices, power can multiply power. That means these 2 can multiply x. So we have what? 2x. So this is 3 to the power of 2x as 2 multiplies s. And now since the base are equal, we can equate the powers. That means I can write root x equal to 2x. Now, square root in indices can be written as a power of half. That is how to write square root. Power of half equal to 2 to power x. In order to make this easy, we can divide both sides by x so that all s are on the left hand side. So let me divide both sides by half, by x. So this is x to power 1 over 2 divided by x equal to, this is 2x divided by x. Now see what will happen. In indices, this is raised to power 1, right? Good. And in indices, since the base are equal, I can take one of the base and subtract the powers if they are dividing. So half minus 1 gives you negative half equal to, you can see that x can go with x here, right? Remaining 2. Now, in order to get the value for x, I'm going to take the power, I'm going to multiply the powers by negative 2. So watch what will happen. This is x to power minus half. I'm going to multiply this by negative 2. Why am I multiplying by negative 2? It's because I know that negative, when multiplied by negative, gives you positive. And I know that half times 2 gives you 1. That means these 2 can go with these 2. They can cancel off. And whatever I do to the left, I will also do to the right. That means if I'm multiplying the power of the left by negative 2, I should also take the negative 2 power of the other side. You get it? Good. Now, watch what will happen. Negative becomes positive. 2 cancels 2. Now I am left with s. So x is equal to 2 to the power of minus 2. You see that? Good. Now, you know, negative power indicates inverse. So that means this 2 to the power of negative 2 can also be written as 1 over 2 to the power of 2. That means the inverse. And you know that 1 over 2 to the power 2 gives what? 4. That means the value of x is equal to 1 over 4. You can see how simple this is. And applying simple laws of indices gets you your answer. Well, if you like this video and you enjoy this video, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't. Turn on the notification bell so you don't miss my future videos. Please subscribe, because it definitely helped me out. I know this is a small channel. In order to reach many people as much as possible, we need your help to grow this channel. Until next time, take care.